हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर पार्थ ठक्कर फ्रॉम एल जे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडेज सेशन इज़ फॉर द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर सब्जेक्ट। इन टुडेज सेशन वी विल फर्स्ट डिस्कस दैट व्हाट वी हैव लर्न्ड इन प्रीवियस थर्मोडायनेमिक सब्जेक्ट। देन वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंस बिटवीन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड हीट ट्रांसफर, देन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर एंड इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर इन इंजीनियरिंग। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट टॉपिक दैट व्हाट वी हैव लर्न्ड इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। In our thermodynamics subject, we have learned first law of thermodynamics, which is expression of principle of conservation of energy, that tells us that energy can neither created nor destroyed, but it can only converted from one form to the another form. Second law of thermodynamics, which tells about the direction of heat transfer, that heat can only transfer from high temperature system to the lower temperature system whenever there is a temperature difference between the two systems. Then we have learned zeroth law of thermodynamics, which tells about the equilibrium condition between the systems. We also have learned some other terms like entropy, enthalpy, energy in the form of heat and work. So these all are the basic concepts of thermodynamics which we have learned in our previous semesters. So the question is that why there is a need to learn another thermal subject like a heat transfer? What is the limitation of thermodynamics that we need to learn heat transfer subjects? So to better understand answer of this question, let's take one example. Suppose we have one cup of tea, which temperature is much higher than the surrounding. If we put this tea in surrounding, we know that the warm cup of tea in the room cools down, the temperature of this tea will decreases. This is accomplished by the transfer of energy from the warm medium to the cold. According to second law, the energy transfer will always from the higher temperature medium to the lower temperature one, and the energy transfer will stop when the two medium reach the same temperature. It means after, we all know that after some time the temperature of this hot tea will same as the surrounding temperature, because the heat will flow from this hot system to the cold system, to the surrounding. We can find out the amount of heat transfer from this system to the surrounding, and we can say that after some time the temperature of this T will be the same as the ambient surrounding temperature. But if we want to find out the heat transfer rate, that the how much time it will take to reach the equilibrium condition, so we cannot find out the answer of this question by only concept of thermodynamics. So we cannot find out heat transfer rate only by concept of thermodynamics. This is the limitation of thermodynamics. Take one more example, and we are more interested, generally in practice we are more concerned about the rate of heat transfer than amount of heat transfer. Suppose we have one thermos in which there is a coffee at a temperature of 80 degrees. We know that as time goes, the temperature of that inside coffee will decreases to 75 degrees Celsius. We can determine the amount of heat transfer from this thermos bottle as the hot coffee inside cools from 80 to 75 degrees. We can find out the amount. But as an engineer, as a designer of thermos, primarily interested in how long it will take to reach the 75 degree for the coffee, and thermodynamic analysis cannot answer this question. So determining the rate of heat transfer to or from a system, and thus the time of cooling or heating, as well as variation of the temperature, is the subject of heat transfer, which is a limitation for the thermodynamics. So what we have learned, that thermodynamics deals with the amount of energy in form of heat or work during a process, and only consider the end state in equilibrium. It will tell us the direction of heat transfer. It will not give information about how long it will take to reach the final state in equilibrium. Whereas in heat transfer, we deal with the rate of heat transfer, rate of energy transfer. Thus, it gives idea how long a heat transfer will occur, how much time it will take for a system to reach an equilibrium state. So heat transfer deals with the time and not equilibrium phenomena. This is the basic and most important difference between thermodynamics and heat transfer. So, what is the general application of heat transfer? There are general application in we see on day-to-day life that heating system, air conditioning system, refrigerator, water heaters, iron, these all systems are designed on the basis of heat transfer analysis to minimize heat loss in winter season and minimizing heat gain in summer season. Now, what is the importance of heat transfer in terms of engineering? In engineering, so that in industry we have some equipment like heat exchanger, boiler or radiator or condenser or refrigerators or furnace or heaters. These all components are designed based on heat transfer analysis, and this analysis mainly based on two problems. First one is a rating problem and second one is sizing problem. Now, what is this rating problem? Rating means heat transfer rating problems. The rating problem deal with the determination of heat transfer rate for an existing system at specified temperature difference. So in this case, at a specified temperature difference, we have to find out the heat transfer rate. Whereas in a second is a sizing problem where the heat transfer rate is fixed. The sizing problem deal with the determination of size of a system in order to transfer heat at a specific rate. In this type of problem, the heat transfer rate is fixed, and according to that, we have to design the size of our equipment. So, what we have learned in our today's session, that what is the difference between heat transfer and thermodynamics, why there is a need to introduce a subject of heat transfer, what are the limitations of thermodynamics, what kind of components are involved in heat transfer, and what kind of problem we are going to solve in heat transfer subject. So this is for the today's introductory session. Thank you.